Hey guys, it's Jaleel again. Somebody asked me today, his name is Julie D. He said, as a reservist, would you say that your work schedule generally sticks to the advertised 1 week in a month, 2 consecutive weeks per year formula, or do they call you in for more work if they need it? So I was going to speak to you all and answer his question about the whole reserve life and what is it like. So let's get right to it. Okay, first thing first, 9 out of 10, your reserve unit is gonna be in East Point, Georgia. Every single 25 Victor goes to the same place, no matter where you're going or no matter where you're from. You're gonna end up at the same place with me. So if you're thinking about being a reservist as a 25 Victor, you're most likely gonna see me at the 982nd. That's what our unit is called, 982nd. So yeah, that's in East Point, Georgia. And you do show up there 1 weekend a month, every single month. Some weekends it's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and some weekends it's only Saturday and Sunday, okay? But it is only 1 weekend a month, and they don't call you in for anything extra than that. Now, so I'm gonna hit a couple of facts about the unit. First thing first is you will get paid for those days that you go to the unit on that weekend. Now, it's nowhere near the amount of money you're getting paid when you're on active duty. So don't get that mixed up. It's nowhere near how much you're getting paid as you're on active duty because you are on reserve status, right? And also, don't think that you're sleeping overnight. It's not you go Friday and you sleep Saturday and Sunday. You go Friday, you come back. You go Saturday, you come back. You go Sunday, you come back. We have to be there at 6:30 to sign in, and then 7 o'clock is our first formation. You usually finish at around 5 o'clock, okay? It could be 3 o'clock, it could be 4 o'clock, it could be 5 o'clock, but just put your mind at 5 o'clock because, you know, if you go home earlier, you'd be like, hurry, okay? So set your mind for 5 o'clock. That's how I do it. Okay, so when you get there, you do PT in the morning. You do PT at 7 o'clock. PT is, you know, simple. You know, you do the whole extend to the left, march, blah, blah, blah. And then when you finish that, you go change, you go, you know, it goes on with the training day, okay? Every training day is different. I know next month we're doing a company-wide PT test. And then the month after that, we're going to the range, right? And it's still only for that weekend. So it doesn't extend over the weekend. They don't call you in during the week, nothing like that. Okay, so go back to what I was saying. This reserve unit is for everybody. 9 out of 10, no matter what. If you're a reservist as a 25 Victor, you're gonna be here. Also, if you're a reservist as a 25 Mike, you're gonna be here, okay? So what that means, say you live 30 plus miles away, what they'll do is they will pay you travel expenses. So they'll pay you if you have to drive down, if it's a long, long drive. They'll reimburse you for gas. They'll even reimburse you for eating food on the way there, right? And then they will pay for your hotel. So you say you go to Valdosta, okay? I'll use that as an example. Say you go to Valdosta and you have to come to East Point, Georgia for the 2 days out of the month. I mean, the 1 weekend out of the month. They will pay for your hotel. You come in Thursday, you sleep there, and then Friday you go to drill, and then you go back to the hotel, you go to drill, back to the hotel, you go back to the drill, right? Now, if you're like me and you live really close to East Point, you're not gonna get a hotel because I don't need a hotel. I live within that 30 mile range, and I think the range is 30 miles, so don't fact check me on that. Just know if you pass a certain mileage on how far you live, they will give you a hotel and they will reimburse you for gas and food on the way there. And then on Sunday, when it's finished, you check out your hotel and you go home. So hopefully you understand the whole hotel setup. Also, we're photographers, right? So like I said, the great thing about our MOS is we have to cover every single event. So they need photographers who can do everything. So what our MOS provides that many other MOS doesn't provide is you could do any training that you like. So say for example, you wanna go to airborne school, we can do that. You want to go to Pathfinder school, we can do that. You want to go to air assault school, you can do that. Now, many MOSs, they don't even know what those things are. But our MOS does, because we need people who are able to do anything, because you need to be able to capture the moment on anything, right? So if you come to the unit and you're interested in airborne school or you're interested in air assault school, you can sign up and then you can do that. I believe airborne school is 3 weeks long, air assault school is 10 days long. So if you're interested in that, you can sign up. So if you're wondering about how deployment is like, everybody who's been there tells me that It's voluntary. You volunteer if you want to get deployed. And all deployments are 9 months long. So say you have a lot of free time and you're not doing anything, you're not in school, and you want to make some extra pay, you want to make some active duty pay again, you can sign up to be deployed, and then they'll let you know when's the next deployment. And there's a list. There's a long list. So, you know, it might be a minute before you get on that chance, because there's people right there, right now at the unit, who's already signed up to be deployed and who's waiting on when is their chance to go. And then if you're not interested in being deployed, or if you're in school and you're busy and you don't have the time, then, you know, you don't, there's people have been there for 6 years, even longer, and said that they was never told, hey, you have to go. Or they don't know anybody who's ever been told, hey, you have to go. They said that everybody who wanted to be deployed volunteered, and then that's how they got deployed. So that's that. So I wouldn't say you don't worry about ever being deployed, but I'm just saying that it hasn't happened in the last 10 plus years. Nobody has been told, hey, you've been deployed. That's coming from everybody who's at the union, because I've been asking around on how it all works. And everybody, and then there's people there, like I said, who have already signed up because they want to be deployed, because they want to make that extra money. They're not doing anything. They have a lot of free time and they want to travel and enjoy the world. So if you're interested in that type of thing, definitely this unit is available. If you're interested in classes like Airborne School, Air Assault School, definitely this place is on, you know, it does all of that stuff. So that's what the reserve life is. Yes, it is 1 weekend out the month, and I'm starting school in January, and like I said, so everything works out perfectly. They don't call you up or anything like that. You don't even hear from them until they don't hit you up at all. You don't hear from them until the weekend comes. They're very nice over there. So like I said, if you're a 25 Victor and you're a reservist, you're most likely going to come to my unit, 982nd, and you'll realize the staff is very nice. It's very calm. It's a very easy environment. It's nothing like AIT. It's nothing like basic training, okay? It's not that intense. People are more laid back, you know, because people have lives, people have jobs, people are doing things, people are all over the about. They just came for the weekend. You know, you get accountability to make sure that you're able to do a PT test. We do PT tests. If you have any documents, if you need like forms or whatnot, there's a lot of opportunities and stuff out there at the unit. You just ask people what is going on. If you want to get involved, or if you're busy, or if you have school, they'll help you with how to transfer your credits from AIT to school. They'll help you with tuition assistance, if you got a bonus, if you got a student loan repayment plan. You know, those are the place that the unit is where you bring up those questions, and then they'll tell you what to do and whatnot. And it's very straightforward, very simple. So just don't be afraid about, oh, I'm coming here to go to school, but you know, I want to start school and whatnot. It's not like that at all. It's very, very calm and easy environment. In fact, I just finished my drill weekend last week, and I'll be posting the video on how it was, and then you'll get a chance to see the building and see how it is. There's not really much to say about it. It is what they said reserve is like, is exactly what they said reserve is like. You know, we go by many names: part-time soldier, weekend warrior, all that stuff. I'm actually thinking about if I should do airborne school or air assault school, because like I don't start school till January. I have a couple of free time. Airborne school is only 3 weeks. Airsoft school is only 10 days. And if you go to those schools, you will be on active duty again. So I will be, because I think anything longer than a weekend is considered active duty. So if I go to airborne school for 3 weeks, I'll be paid as active duty member for 3 weeks. And if I go to air assault school for 10 days, I'll be paid as an active duty member for 10 days. And then I come right back here and go on with life like nothing happened. Right before I start school in January, because I'm starting school in January at Georgia State. So, you know, so if you have any questions about the reserve, you know, definitely comment. I just wanted to make this video to reply to his question, to raise up any concerns, because like I said, nobody's telling you any of this. I didn't know any of this before I joined. It's definitely a great experience to know. It's definitely something that I want to further the understanding and educate people who don't know and who are interested. Definitely, if you're thinking about being a 25 Victor, I can't wait to see you. Definitely keep me updated on how AIT is going. And also, you know, if you're really into it, make some videos and further the knowledge. Tell people what AIT life is like. And then when you come back here, I can't wait to see you. So that's about it. Oh, before I forget, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and definitely stay nerdy. Also, you can purchase this nerd tee on my website, NerdSQ. Outside of the military, I have my own clothing business, as you may not know. So definitely the link will be in the description below, and thanks for watching.